Okay, here's a new filament mount. This is designed with an endstop switch in it, so it's a little bit easier to use. So if you look on the side, it's got a 1.75 millimeter hole that goes through it. To load it, you just slide it right through, and there you go. Now to install, this is pretty simple. You're just going to take the motor and connect it like you would normally do for E0. And then for the switch mount, do a little bit differently because the wiring has to be specific. So I'm putting in these extenders to make it a little easier to follow. So red's going to be 5 volts. You're going to have to set a jumper on your VCC and 5 volts here. So that you can power your rail. Now the actual pins we're going to use for this one are the third pin over, and it's ground. 5 volts signal. So green is signal. That goes right there. Then you have 5 volts. Then you have ground. Now for the LCDs, I found something weird going on. This LCD will work, but you have to disable SD support and run it from something like Pronterface. This is the RepRap discount full graphics. This is the RepRap discount, and it'll work on this one with both the SD and with Pronterface. So in the next part of the video, I'll show you how it works.
Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin 1.1.6. We're going to go to Marlin. We're going to search on Marlin. Open up the solution file. We're going to find the configuration tab. We're going to do a search on LCD and. And we're going to enable LCD support. Or excuse me, SD support. We're then going to enable speaker. We're then going to enable LCD feedback frequency duration MS and LCD feedback frequency in Hertz. We're then going to search on RepRap discount . We're going to uncomment that for the LCD panel. And then we're going to search on Runout. And we're going to uncomment Filament Runout Sensor. We're going to change Filament Runout Inverting to True, because this is an Endstop switch. And then we're going to go to Advanced. For configuration advanced, do a search on, let's see, advanced pause. We're going to uncomment that. As you can see, there's various settings in here that you can select from, but we're not going to touch that at the moment. You can figure that out on your own. We're going to go back to the Marlin folder for a second. We're going to search on pins. We're going to locate pins underscore ramps. And inside here, we have a filament width pin. That's the one we're actually on, but it's pin 5. But we're using the filament runout pin. So we're going to call this 4 for now, and this 5, thus swapping the pins that we're actually on. We'll save that. We'll go back to ramps, or excuse me, we'll go back to Marlin, and then we'll compile and upload. Okay, now we're going to go over to Pronterface. We're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect, and we're going to type M119. It says it's triggered. Now let's pull out the filament. Do the same command again, and now it says open. So in the next step, I'll show you how we have it all wired up, and then I'll show you how to actually cause the error.
Okay, here's the filament set up in the Endstop switch sensor. It's connected to the motor. Here's the actual LCD we're going to use. I'm going to have to put a film over it so you can see it, because I have to change the light, and it doesn't seem to read very well in the light that I'm in. And then here's the regular configuration that I showed you on the basic board earlier. So let me put the filament over it here for you, and then I'll show you what we're doing in Pronterface.
Okay, we're gonna connect to the device, double check the setting for the filament, and it looks like it's triggered, which is good. Now we're gonna load a file to print, and we're gonna say print.
Okay, it's about to print. It's gonna throw an error almost right away. So it's just run out of filament. There's the message. It says print paused, wait for filament unload nozzle, and then it says what the temperature is, and it's actually moving the motor backwards. Now it's throwing a message to insert filament and press continue. Now it's paused, waiting for filament. And that's all there is to it. If you like my video, please press the like button. And thank you for your time. And don't forget to subscribe.